I'm not going to last forever. Fortunately, this company has never been about me. Our business has never been built on personalities. Our business is built on principles. And the personalities, the people, they come and go, but the principles last forever. And so that's why we focus on principles. That's why we teach so much about principles, because that's what we're dependent on. And but, you know, somebody has to fly the plane. So I've been flying the plane for some 37 years almost. And I've been really blessed to have that opportunity to fly the plane. I've enjoyed every single minute of it. But again, I'm not going to be around forever. And so the board of directors, we have a board of directors. We have a really phenomenal board made up of inside directors and outside directors. The inside directors, that's employees of the company, members of the management team. You know many of them. Serve on my board of directors. And then we have some outside directors. Outside directors are not employees, but they are great minds, business minds in their own right. They've had business careers elsewhere, and we use them as consultants. And over the years, they've said, Frank, you need to have a succession plan. Well, of course, I need to have a succession plan. I've always agreed with that, and my answer has been, I have a whole stable of young men and women who are coming up through the ranks. Some have been with us for decades, and others are newer. They're bright, energetic, passionate. And if, you know, someday, you know, they'll run the company someday. And they've said, well, but Frank, you know, you need to tell us what, I understand you're going to be around for a long time, but what happens if you get hit by a truck? And so my response to that is, how big of a truck did you have in mind? And they said, well, you know, something could happen. And so they said, well, you know, and I said, I know who my successor would be. They said, well, name, and I said, I'll tell you, I just don't think now's the time to name that publicly. And they said, well, put it in a video. I said, what do you mean? Well, we'll put it in a video. Tell us in it. So if something happens to you, we'll get out the video and see who you left in charge then. And I said, okay, I'll do that. And so, and for the last 5 or 6 years, twice a year, I interview every single member of my staff, my management team, confidentially, individually, in private. And I've asked them the question, as we've always anticipated, you know, succession planning, and I've asked him, who should be in charge if I were to get hit by a truck? Who? And for the last 5 years, it's been the same person. Every time, they all unanimous, they named the same person. So anyway, I did the video about 6 months ago, and in the video, I named the person. It's kind of interesting to do a video like that because, and I did it, you know, in private, it wasn't public. And I did the video, and in the video, you know, saying something like, if you're watching this, then I'm no longer here. So thank you for everything. And here's the person that's now in charge, and the credentials of the person, and so on. So I did that video 6 months ago, and then I got to thinking. Ever since I did the video, I thought, you know what? He's ready now. He's ready now. And he is so much better than I am or ever will be. And I'm starting to think, well, what, then why not now? And the more I thought about it, the more I thought, you know, maybe it's time that I let him fly this airplane. Because he could do it so much better than me. So now, but let me explain about flying airplanes for a minute. So, if you fly an airplane, you go into the cockpit, and there's left seat and right seat. There's two folks up there, two people in that cockpit. The left-hand person is the pilot. He's flying the plane. That's the pilot. The right-hand person is the navigator. And the navigator, together they decide on destination, and the navigator charts the course. And then the pilot flies the plane. That's how it happens in an airplane. So the right seat's the navigator, the left seat is the pilot. And for all these years, I've been the pilot, but I'm going to move over to the right seat now. I'm staying on the plane. I'm going to be on the plane. The right seat has controls, but you don't touch them unless it's an emergency. The pilot flies the plane. And so I'm going to name a new CEO in about 2 minutes. But I just want to let you know I'm still on the plane. I'm not going anywhere. And the new CEO of Melaleuca is going to be Jerry Felton. And let me tell you a few things about Jerry. He deserves that. We're gonna invite him out here in a minute. But let me tell you a few things about Jerry that you need to know. Because Jerry's been with Melaleuca now for 13 years. Over the last 10, he has been president of Melaleuca International, running all of our international businesses. And prior to Melaleuca, he was with UPS, 17 years with UPS, climbing the ranks through the ranks of UPS, big, huge, huge company, one of the largest companies in America. He climbed up through the ranks. He started as a district manager, then regional sales manager, then national sales manager. He spent 4.5 years in Hong Kong as the Asia Pacific sales director of UPS's Asia Pacific enterprises. Then he became the vice president of supply chain solutions for Europe. That was over the Europe, the Mideast, Africa, and Asia. And he was in Belgium. He lived in Belgium then with his family for 2.5 years. His wonderful wife Sandra, and his family have followed him all over the world. And then he finished up. He moved to UPS headquarters in Atlanta, and finished up the last 3 years with UPS. He was vice president of global sales for all of UPS. And then you say, how in the world did we get him? But we did. About 14 years ago, we recruited him to come join Melaleuca. So 14 years ago, Jerry was senior vice president of sales. That's the position that Darren Johnson has today. And Jerry served as senior vice president of sales of Melaleuca for 3.5 years. And then I asked him to be we prospered. We absolutely prospered during his tenure. You can see it on the growth charts. Grew consistently year after year after year. And then I asked him to take over our international operations, all the countries except for U.S., Canada, and Mexico. He's been running that for the last 10 years as president of Melaleuca International. During Jerry's tenure internationally, we have tripled in size under his leadership, tripled in size. He knows Melaleuca forward and backwards. He guided all of our international countries through COVID. His people all over the world love him. I love him. I know that you love him. He loves his people, and he loves you. He knows Melaleuca through and through, and he's so much better than what I could ever be as a CEO in so many ways. And he is ready to fly this plane. And just a note before I bring up about right being in the right seat. So I've been practicing being in the right seat now for a little while. So in my family growing up, it was kind of, you know, being the driver was kind of a macho thing. My father, if we were in our old 1957 Rambler, my dad would drive, and if my mom was there, she'd always sit right seat. I mean, dad would drive, and mom, and all us kids, dad's driving. If dad wasn't there, then mom would drive, but if dad's there, he's always driving. So that's kind of how I grew up, and when Belinda and I dated, I always drove on our dates. I'm driving. It's kind of a, you know, it's, and then we got married and had kids, and I always drive. I'm the man of the house, I'm driving. about 3 years ago, she said, honey, can I drive? I said, no, it's my job to drive. She said, but honey, you're always on the phone, you're talking, and you know, sometimes you're not paying attention, and I mean, you know, I could drive and you be on the phone and you do your thing, and maybe that'd work better. So about 3 years ago, we go out on dates. We go on dates, maybe we try to do once a week. So she's, for the last 3 years, she's been driving. And you know what? I like it. She's driving, and I'm on the phone, or I'm looking, taking notes, or you know, doing my thing and visiting, and I don't have to pay attention. I mean, I'm doing my thing, what I want to do. Here's what I learned. Being in the right seat, I always end up where I want to end up. With Belinda driving, we always end up where, and not because I'm saying, I mean, we agree on it, and she always takes me to where we want to go. So I've been practicing that now. And it works pretty good. Works really well. My new title is going to be executive chairman. I'm going to have some direct reports. I'm going to keep marketing and legal. And everything else is going to report to Jerry Felton. And he's going to fly the plane. So I'd like to introduce to you the CEO of Melaleuca, Mr. Jerry Felton. Yeah, one day, well, the sky might fall. Yeah, one day.
So, thank you. John Wooden, Lou Holtz, Pat Summitt, Vince Lombardi, Bear Bryant, Frank Robinson, Coach K. I know you guys know who these people are. But for everybody else, these are Hall of Fame coaches and leaders. They were legacies. They made a significant impact in their space. I've always felt so sorry for those poor suckers who had to follow them. And I'm so happy that I have nothing to worry about here. I'm sorry. I want to thank you guys. I don't deserve that warm Melaleuca welcome. But I do, I'm standing here, and I proudly represent 5,000 devoted, committed, loyal Melaleuca employees all around the world who are committed to you every day and serving you and helping you reach your goals. So on behalf of them, I thank you. And like many of you right now, I've got a few emotions going on. Weight, responsibility, excitement, humility, respect, and if I'm completely honest, a little bit of fear. The cool thing about this new role is apparently I finally get to get my pilot's license. You know, Frank just said a lot of really nice things about me, and I do strive to live up to those things. But I'd like to introduce to you the better side of me, my family. I shared with the leaders this morning this photo. Got a lot of photos of my family. We got lots, tons. But this one was taken 16 years ago. It sits on all my screensavers. When my phone turns on in the morning, this is what I see. When my phone goes to sleep and I pop it, this is what I see. It sits on my laptop. It reminds me of who I am and where I'm headed. My wife calls it our tribe. And Sandra is the best part of this photo. We've shared 34 years of our life together. She's an amazing woman. She's an incredible mom. God knew our kids would need her. And she's been a blessing to them. Our oldest is 31, and my youngest turns 18 this week. So this is a dated photo, but this means a lot to me. This is my why. This is what's most important to me. It drives me. It grounds me. And it gives me clarity in the things that I want to do in life. And I love my why. Frank mentioned that I received a call from a headhunter 14 years ago. At the time, obviously, at UPS. I had a great career. I was proud of my career. Fortune 100 company. And to this day, I still have some brown in my blood. I wasn't interested at first, but he pushed me to at least have a conversation, so I agreed. And I met with Frank, and I met with the management team, and then I flew home, and then Sandra and I flew to Idaho, and we met with Frank and Belinda and the management team, and we decided to join Melaleuca. Why? Well, you guys know Frank. He's persistent. He's very persuasive. But what I heard and what I saw was intriguing. A company with one-of-a-kind products, with patents and science, a company with a mission that as you walked through the halls of the old home office, people actually knew the mission. They knew the statement, and I believe they lived the mission. A company that actually believed they made a difference in people's lives, and a company that actually had principles and values that were as important to me. A company with a purpose beyond simply profits to benefit shareholders. I saw a company that didn't make short-term decisions to affect the quarterly stock price. And I learned that Melaleuca was a company that was also debt-free. That's what I heard. That's what I liked. But I wasn't sure. I was like many of you. When you first hear about Melaleuca, you're not quite sure, but it sounds great. So Sandra and I, we decided to take a leap of faith based on what we learned, and here I am, almost 14 years later, and I'm standing here right now because I've seen it. I've experienced it, every last bit of it. Our mission is not a concept. It's not a theory. It's not wishful thinking. It's for real. To me, it's real. And I've experienced it with you and through you. Every one of you are proof positive that our mission is real. And I believe in what we do. I believe we make a difference. I've experienced it all around the world, and it's profoundly unique, and I love it. And I'm so thankful to be a part of your lives and a part of this mission. I've had the good fortune of spending a lot of time with Frank over the past 13 and a half years. He's my manager, my mentor, my teacher, my friend. To say that I've learned a lot would be an understatement, for sure, and I can appreciate this fact. And I'm sure you all would agree. There's not a single one of us in this room right now that would be here today if it weren't for Frank. We have a lot to be grateful for, and I, for one, celebrate his legacy. I don't have to convince anyone here that Frank is a rare person and a unique leader. And I'll be the first to acknowledge I'm not Frank. I can't be. But I can be me. And I can and I will carry forward the principles and the values and the traditions that Frank has established over the past nearly 37 years. Sure, I'll bring my unique experience and my perspectives, my sensibilities to the role. But I won't forget the principles that got us here. I'm committed to carrying forward the legacy that Frank and all of you right here have created. When it comes to our mission, I hope you'll be able to see that I'm all in. all in. And I will do everything I can to make sure that you succeed at what it is that you're after, not just here, but around the world. We're at a great time at Melaleuca right now. Our business is strong, it's vibrant, it's growing, it's strong. And our success can be attributed to foundational principles and great leadership. And the culture that we share is special, and it's critical to delivering on our mission. And today, our business model is more relevant and more sustainable than it has ever been. Our future is very, very bright. And we should all be very proud of what we've built under Frank's leadership. One of the many strengths that Frank has is building great teams. And he's assembled a really talented, high-functioning leadership team, from Fortune 500s to decades of experience at Melaleuca. And I am so proud to be a part of that team. And we are a team. We hold ourselves accountable. We inspire each other. We collaborate as a team. We execute as a team. We believe in each other. And everything we do is focused on how we can help you reach your goals. And we'll continue to find ways to enhance the customer experience and improve retention. We'll find ways to make it more efficient for you and everyone to refer more customers and build your business. We'll continue to execute with fiscal responsibility, and we will invest when and where we need to in order to strengthen and build your future. And most important, we'll make promises that we can keep, and we'll keep those promises. Now, finally, I'll close with this thought. I'm not special. I'm not any better than anyone else in this room. We are equally important, and we're equally critical in our mission. We're a team, we're partners, and I believe we're all CEOs. CEOs of our businesses, CEOs of our families, CEOs of our lives. And I am honored and flattered to have the opportunity to share that title with you. I look forward to serving you, and most important, I look forward to celebrating our future successes for a long, long time. Thank you very much.